but it will take a little time to go into all this water improvement. I want to show you different areas and parts. Let's go, for example, to gold. We had a wonderful lecture yesterday from Isaac. Why is the whole world crazy about gold? Gold always rises in prices. The funny thing is, if I put gold into the water, I get beautiful crystals. So I always say in my lecture, instead of put the gold into the bank, even if my laboratory is in Liechtenstein, which is the hotspot of banks, don't put it into the bank, put it to your water. I have in my water tap at home, in the inlet, and in every outlet I have a little gold. Just a little, so it's not worth to break into my house, but at least the quality of the water changed completely. So water and gold fits perfectly together. Why it's like this, I don't know yet. Funniest thing is that all kings around the world had always the gold around their brain. And the brain is over 90% of water, and maybe it's just philosophically, but an emperor or the guy or the woman in charge should be a little bit smart, because they have quite some responsibility. But we did a lot of testing. This was the testing I did in the Moscow University, in the biggest concrete laboratory of Russia, because I had the access there. And we made testing to change the water. And the results were mind-blowing. It was really, first I tested this in a big laboratory in Munich, and then I went with this to Russia. We used turbines made of gold, the water, and then we made concrete, you know, concrete beton. And the funny thing is, when we made it with this gold, the concrete became 10% more hard. And during the process, the concrete was 10% more fluid. Normally use a lot of chemicals to make concrete fluid to pump it up all the floors. So amazing results, but the problem is just nobody's interested in that, because there are millions invested in chemistry, and if you would save this money, I don't know, it's strange that so far no company was interested in the results. This is another wonderful work. It's a work of Dr. Ibrahim Karim. It was for me like this, that I worked for Emoto several years, so in cooperation with him, and I got to the point where I didn't understand what I do. I just thought, is this magic, or what? I couldn't explain it. And then we have been invited to Egypt, and I met this wonderful scientist, and his family is since several generations studying biogeometry, which means the interaction of vibration into form. And he and his father and his grandfather have been advisor on the highest level, or advisor in the Arabic world. So they take it very serious, this kind of work, I'll call it like this. And he told me, actually very simple, you have to study the studies of Pythagoras and the study of the note of sound to understand water. And this comes a little later, but this is just the work of him, and I got wonderful results. Now, I have always tried in this work to make a bridge between belief and science. Because I always had difficulties with belief. Belief is conditioning. If you grew up in India, you would all believe in Shiva. And no adult questions this. They just accept, I grew up in Finland or Sweden or Austria, and I believe what my parents have told me. And the word tradition derives from treason. And treason is betray. So you have to think, is it so important to follow always the steps left behind? Because the Christianity had more wars than all other religions together in the last 2,000 years now, but they put the last 5,000 years together. So I always, and this is an event of peace, and I always had my difficulty with belief, with thought, and I will show you later what thought can do, directly impact on your heart. But I always try to make bridges. I mean, if you see, for example, the word angel, angels has a quality, yes? Beauty, whatever, Michael, whatever they're called. The word angle in science is an angle, 50 degrees, 90 degrees, whatever. But it's very similar. It's a coincidence, maybe I'm crazy, doesn't matter. There is some similarities. And now when you go to holy geometry, I have special angles. Maybe you know about holy geometry, some people have heard about this, it's beautiful to study. So some angles have like a quality of an angel. They have beautiful qualities. So the holy spots, or the healing spots, or all the cathedrals and temples and mosques, And the people before they knew about this, and they built according to angles. And then we start to believe, which is also fine. But I made a wonderful experiment. You know the water of Lourdes. Lourdes is very famous, the Lourdes water. And I tested normal tap water, Lourdes water, purified chemical, purified salt, and normal rock salt of the mountain. And I made all kinds of combinations, what is possible. But only the combination of Lourdes water and the pure salt, the normal salt of the mountain, I made a dilution. I put it on a glass slide, I let it dry, and the salt crystals disappeared again. They had an angle of 108 degrees, not 90 degrees. Maybe you can see it here. So, quite interesting. And when you have, for example, the flower of life, you know the flower of life? Johannes has a wonderful lecture to talk about this. If two circles are cutting each other, you have in the center the eye of the Ra, our eye. And if I make here a triangle, I have exactly 108 degrees in the eye. So the angle has also quality. Let's go a little further. When we have a sunrise in every culture, every human, if he is not completely stubborn or in his mind, when he sees a sunrise or a sunset, he makes a short pause and just is touched by it. But why is it like this? Is it just because day and night, or good or bad, or whatever? The funny thing is, when you have a stone in the river, and the water flows over the stone, what happens behind the stone? The water starts to make a vortex. Yes? And we learned in university, it was quite funny, in Austria, a professor told that we don't know until today how a river can mineralize the amount it does. What means mineralize? All the leaves and all this organic matter falling into the river gets back to the minerals, back to calcium, magnesium. And also, normally the microorganisms, they are digesting all this, but if you make a calculation, they cannot mineralize as much as there is mineralized in the river. And now the interesting thing is, that's at least a theory, then maybe you heard about implosion. You have a vortex, and other you have the other side of the vortex. At the moment, it goes to zero, the organic matter is mineralized. So back to the experiment we do here. If you have a sunrise, and you have the, when this is the Earth, and here's the sun, and the sun rises, and you stand here, the moment the sun rises, just behind you, all the photons get into a vortex. So this is like a sacred moment during the day, the morning and in the evening. I made a beautiful experiment. It was a coincidence. I had to test the tap water of Moscow, which is pretty terrible and doesn't look so nice. And I had to test it, and then I tested it again and again. And one day I got the most amazing crystals, and I thought, this can't be, I must have made a big mistake. But the funny thing is, at that night there was a moon darkening, like an eclipse. So the constellations of the stars are also a quality, which the Maya calendar or any calendar, Stonehenge or everything, they have known about this and they talked about this. So water reacts on vibration. This is, we make many experiments and invited in many ceremonies. We had peace ceremonies in Israel, in Palestina, in Brazil. We had in Siberia one, and this is one we had last year in Fukushima, 35 kilometers next to the reactor, which blew. And we made a ceremony there. This is wonderful ceremony which comes from India, which is said is several thousand years old, where you have a copper pyramid, and exactly in the morning you burn, make a fire, when the sun rises, and the sunset. And you can say, scientific, what are you doing there? But the interesting thing is that ashes are always cleaning. Yes. For sure you have done it in ancient times here too, so we took ash to clean our teeth, or we had ashes to clean our body. Chemically, you know, activated carbon is the best thing to absorb all the chemicals, hormones in the water. So what did I do? I took this ash. Beautiful was during the ceremony, sunrise, the whole sky opened. It's a coincidence, maybe not. But it was beautiful. And so I took this ash and I put it into the water. And the amazing thing, the whole structure of the water changed. So this is the water from Tokyo after the radioactive blow, before, and then I took the ash into the water and it changed completely. And even chemically, you can say it's hardly a difference because I use so little. But you can see that you can change the quality of the water. Now I want to come to another kind of work, which is not from Emoto, which actually shows the same, but it's a more easy way, I'd say. You just have a glass slide, a piece of glass, and you take a syringe and you make small drops. And you let the drops dry, and then you examine it in the dark field microscope. Dark field means that the light comes from the side, and the viewer, the objective is from above, which means that you have a bigger contrast, and you can more easily examine the structure of a sample. You can test anything, a tree or spring water, and you just look at the remaining minerals on the glass. Water from Machu Picchu and from other countries. And for example, if you apply radioactivity, and even if the water is not radioactive itself, like in the cooling from the power plants, power stations, the water under the microscope changes. So we change the entire river, even if we cannot measure the chemistry. But we change the structure of the water. This is also a little radioactive